In the previous sessions, we have discussed about how to make a transistor work as an amplifier and how to make a transistor stabilized during the time of amplification and various other aspects which affects the amplification, like stability, thermal disturbances and some other stability distractions, and how to make them stable, make the transistor parameters stable regardless temperature and etc. Now in this chapter we will learn about small signal amplifiers. In the name it is indicated that small signal, that means a small signal is nothing but signal which is having less amplitude, that is with microvolts, millivolts at the input side. It is having very low voltage and getting high voltage, that is high amplitude at the output. These type of transformations in the voltage level and in the amplification level, that is it is taking a very less voltage at the input and giving out very high voltage at the output, is called a small signal amplifier. We have used active devices like transistors to make amplifiers. In the previous chapter we have learned about this, and now we are seeing small signal amplifiers. In small signal amplifiers, at the practical stage we will not get more amplification output or amplified output to drive a load having or required heavy voltage or currents, but we can drive small buzzers, small LEDs which are having rating of 2 voltage or 5 volts, but not more than that. So to gain more amplification, practically they will be used multi-stage amplifiers for more amplification. At the multi-stage, cascading levels are used to have a high gain at the output. In this chapter we will learn all about transistor configurations, that is different couplings and different type of amplifiers based on the use and based on their specifications. We will use different amplifiers at different places to amplify the small level signals. Two-port network. We have heard about terminals, ports. If two terminals is having a function, that is if the entering current is equal to leaving current in a network, if these two are terminals of a network, then these two terminals together called as a port. And for a port, it is the general operation, that is the entering current must be equal to leaving current. If a network having two ports in such a way, then it is called two-port network. Some examples of single port networks are R, L, C networks. In a R network, there will be only one port, that is input port. In a C network, there will be only one port, that is input. And at the L also, there will be only one port at the input. In these type of networks, these are called single port networks, and these are having only two terminals. If you go to two port networks, transistor configurations which are having two input terminals and two output terminals, if these are input terminals and if these are output terminals, and these two terminals are together called as a one port, and these two terminals together called as a another port. If a circuit having two ports, then it is called as two port network, and if it is having another port more than two, then it is called as multi-port network. So why this topic is came? Because we are discussing a transistor configurations and transistors and amplifiers which are having input and output networks, and these which are having input and output sides, and which deals with four terminals, that is one terminal. In this topic we will discuss about amplifiers, which will deals with input and output ports, and these ports can be analyzed with a mathematical formulas and different parameters. So let us dive into the real topics. H parameters. For any network there will be different parameters. We can express any network in different parameters ways, that is H parameters, Z parameters, ABCD parameters and etc. In H parameters are identically called hybrid parameters. These are called hybrid parameters. We will understand later. To derive these parameters we have to do the following operations, and for any linear circuit having two ports can be analyzed with four parameters, and those four parameters can be adjusted in a 2 by 2 matrix having 1 1 1 2 and 2 1 2 2 as a subscripts. And if we think this as a two port network, of course it may be a something in this two port network, two port terminal, it is a linear network. Let it be think as something, some black box, and which is having I1 entering current, and this in the, at this port, input port, or at this side port I1 leaving current. These two are similar, so this can be treated as a one port, and at this port I2 is an entering current, at this terminal I2 is leaving current. These two are equal and this can be considered as another port. So this total is a two port network, and let us discuss at these two ports V1 is the voltage source. At these two terminals V1 is the voltage, and at these two terminals V2 is the voltage. So if we derive some mathematical formulas or some mathematical equations from these two port network which are hybrid parameters, then we will get about different parameters about these two port network. Let us see what they are. Let us consider V1 and I2 are dependent variables, that is input voltage and output current are dependent variables, and input current and output voltage are independent variables. With these two independent variables we can derive these two dependent variables. So if we frame an equation about V1 and I2 depending on I1 and V2, then we can write V1 is equal to H11 into I1 plus H12 into V2, and this is about input voltage, and about output current H21 into I1 plus H22 into V2. If we arrange this in a matrix form, H11, H12, H21 and H22, and we can derive these two variables V1 and I2 by multiplying this matrix with V2 and I1. So we can find values of V1 and I2. We can derive the value of V1 and I2 with these two independent variables and these some matrix forms. Then to calculate these two values V1 and I2, we have to make V2 as 0. It means output is short circuited. If output is short circuited, then H11 value will be from V1, from this equation H11 will be V1 divided by I1, and this is in the form of V by I. We can imagine that V by I is equal to R, that is impedance or it is resistance. So this resistance is at input port, so this is termed as input impedance. From the same equation, from the another equation, that is about I2, if we have to calculate the H21, then V2 is 0, then the H21 value will be I2 by I1. This is in the form of output current by input current. This can be termed as current gain, and it is in the forward direction. So this is termed as forward current gain. We have determined H11 value and H2 value by making V2 as 0, that is output is short circuited. Now by making input as open circuited, that is making I1 as 0, by making input current or input port open circuit, we can find the values, that is H11 and H12 and H22. So here it is mistaken, that is H12 will be V1 by V2. We can remember the equation, that is of voltage gain, V2 by V1, that is output voltage by input voltage, that is voltage gain, actual voltage gain, but this is in the reverse direction. So we have termed this as reverse voltage gain, and from the second equation we can find the H22, that is H22 is equal to I2 by V2. We have seen this, that is V by I is equal to R. Now it is in reverse condition, that is I by V is equal to 1 by R. I by V is equal to 1 by R. 1 by R is nothing but admittance. And it is at the output port. So this is named as output admittance. Why this is called, these are called hybrid parameters? Because these are having different units, that is impedance having ohms units, and current gain is having no units, reverse voltage gain is also having no units, output admittance is having most as a units. So these hybrid parameters and are four parameters, and each parameter is having separate units. So these parameters are called as hybrid parameters because of this reason. This is having different units for the same parameters. So this is all about hybrid parameters, and in the later sessions we will discuss about equivalent parameters of different configurations at different configurations and different parameters. And we will have a sudden question, that is why I1 and V2 are independent and V1 and I2 are dependent. We will have this immediate question while discussing about H parameters. This is only because if we consider CE configuration, in the CE configuration the input current I1 is independent, and V2, that is in CE configuration VC, is also independent variables. Because of this cause, we are getting V2 and I1 are independent variables and V1 and I2 are dependent variables. So you can read this complete passage over here.